Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, I want to show you a mandatory part that you must put on your second generation Colt Python. These are the Colt Pythons that were manufactured in year 2020 to present time. Alright, so this is made by Wilson Combat, and as you can read, adjustable battle sight. Alright, it's a rear sight. And this one is actually a U-notch. And I wanted to do this video for a while. I haven't put this thing on my second gen Python, but I'm going to do it right now. So I wanted to kind of show this to you guys and gals out there and just kind of reiterate that if you do have a second gen Python, this is a mandatory piece of equipment, or it's a part that you must get. Well worth the money, and it's better than the stock, what if you want to even call this a rear sight, that's put on from the factory. This thing here is not very good. It moves around. It doesn't stay zeroed either under 357 Magnum recoil. You got that little set screw there for some weird reason. It's just a strange design. And the cut, look at this. It just moves so much. It doesn't stay put. You can use a little bit of Loctite on that set screw and, well, not gonna talk about it. See, this thing, it just moves around. So anyways, I got this taped up. I'm gonna put it in the vise. I'm gonna install this rear Wilson Combat rear sight on here and then show you how it looks. I was gonna change the front sight out to my gold bead, but to be honest with you, I can't find my freaking gold bead front sight, and I'm really bothered by this because I had it like, you know, a couple months ago. So for now, I still have the rear sight here. I looked in my drawers. I cannot find the front gold bead front sight made by Wilson Combat. I don't know. I hope I didn't like freaking lose it or threw it out by accident, which would be weird. But anyways, let's get going with this and talk about this.
I'm going to start here.
Going to turn on the overhead light. We're in the gun room again. Now, what you need is definitely a bench vise. You don't need anything special. This one here is, I think it's from Home Depot, and it probably costs like $35 to $40. Or was it Home Depot? Yeah, this is a Home Depot one. I have another one I think I got off of Amazon for $35 that I think is a little bit better than this one, ironically, and I forgot what brand that was. Irwin, I think. It's blue. $35 on Amazon, and you only need a 4.5-inch vise here, and nothing major. This is for light duty. I mean, you can buy a monster one if you're going to be doing a lot of stuff that needs like high torque, or you know, you're trying to take barrels off. I mean, this one kind of works, but it kind of moves around. So if you're going to be installing barrels, that's a different vise in other side of the room here. Maybe see, I don't really show AR-15 stuff anymore, but that part of the gun room is all rifle stuff. So maybe next year we'll take a closer look at my rifle room, where I have a huge vise, where you can put barrels on, you know, flash hiders, you can take them on and off, and so on and so forth. All right, so this vise here, like I said, is a cheaper one. These jaws right here are made by Otis, I believe. I don't remember. They're stuck on here using magnets. See, these are mandatory. And someone gave these to me, so I don't remember. But they stick on the jaws, just like that. It's not a strong magnet at all. But once you tighten it down, everything works just fine. All right. So I don't know if I'm going to film this, but I'm going to start what I got to do, and I guess I'll be right back, and I'll show you what the rear sight looks like on the second gen plate. All right. So that's what it looks like with the junk sight off the gun. Okay, let me get this rear sight on here. But here's the junk part that they put on the Colt. I'm just gonna throw this in the garbage. That's where it belongs. It's just trash. It's a budget thing, but whatever. They should know better. Figure it out. And there we are. That rear U-notch Wilson Combat rear sight is now on this second gen Python. So just to quickly recap, you'll need basically a bench vise with some jaws that are padded to put your gun in there, put the Python in there, and then you're going to lock it down. And the tools that you'll need, this is very important, is to get a 1/16 punch and another 1/16 roll pin punch. See how that's bent? See, so these aren't very strong, but It's incredibly important to get the 1/16th punch that's gonna fit through this roll, where the roll pin goes through, because not all 1/16th punches are made equally. Meaning, you'll get one from Harbor Freight, and the actual, you know, the measurement of that 1/16th up here is actually not 1/16th, it's a little bit larger. So if you try to force that type of punch through this hole here, you're gonna mar up the finish and, you know, mess things up. It's gonna get stuck in the hole. So it's interesting. So if you try to use a 1/16th punch and it gets kind of stuck in this, you know, in this recessed area, this, you know, where the roll pin goes in, stop what you're doing and try to remove it and get yourself, you gotta go trial and error and buy another 1/16th punch and make sure it goes in to this hole smoothly. There's a bunch of people that I know that have tried to change out the rear sight, and they would go to Harbor Freight and get these punch sets, and they're, the 1/16th actually does not work. It's too big, and they try to force it through that hole and everything gets ruined in here. Then they're in a big jam. So you just gotta make sure you get the right 1/16th. Again, if it goes in here and it starts to feel like it's getting stuck, stop what you're doing immediately and just try to wiggle the punch out of that hole as gingerly as you can, straight out. Don't start pulling it everywhere because you're gonna ruin the actual hole in there. And just pull it back out, and you gotta go out to the shop, go to Lowe's, go to Home Depot, I don't know, go on Amazon and just order another 1/16th and see if that one will work. Sounds weird. So you need the punch, 1/16th inch punch, a roll pin punch, because the top of this, as you can see, is gonna fit into that roll pin. So when you're driving it back in, the pin back in, you need to use this one. It has a little bit of a top on there. See how that works? It fits right into the roll pin. You don't really want to use a flat punch when you're putting it back in. Also, you need a punch starter for sure. You're gonna drop that roll pin in here and then drive it in through the hole, and right before it gets right to the frame, take it off and finish it off with the roll pin punch. It has that little top on there that's gonna fit right into the roll pin. You know, also make sure you got the roll pin facing the right way, meaning this will drop. I don't know if it's flat on both sides on the roll pin, but one side of the roll pin is going to have a little recessed area where this punch will fit into, and you just drive it home. You know, right before you get, I'm sorry, this camera is not focusing. Once you get up right before the frame, you just get right out of there and everything will be a-okay. So you should get three, if you're going to do this yourself, and it's pretty easy if you have the right tools. All right, so I got the rear adjustable sight made by Wilson Combat on this second generation Colt Python right here. It works out very, very well. Like I said, this is a mandatory part that you must get for your second generation Colt Python. The stock rear sight that comes on this second gen Python is subpar. I mean, if you want to keep it on there, be my guest, but for anything serious, you gotta get that thing off there and put this Wilson Combat rear sight on your gun immediately. It is well worth the $110 it is, plus tax and shipping. Well worth the money, just do it. Hell, if you get the Colt Python second gen, just buy one of these, all right? I put the old sight, I was gonna throw it in the trash, but I put it back in here. But for real, this Colt, this, you know, the factory installed rear sight, adjustable sight is garbage in my eyes. Oh, there's a screw came out. But I'm gonna keep it in this box here, why not? So definitely get this. Now this is the U-notch version, as you can see right here. All right, this is the U-notch version. I like a U-notch because it's somewhat quicker in acquisition. But anyways, I'm gonna keep on the red-orange front ramp. Red ramp, orange, whatever color this is, you wanna call it, on the gun. And you know what, I'll probably just order from Wilson Combat a gold bead front sight for this, because I like a gold bead. But as I was looking at this, if you look at this U-notch right here, okay, just like that, see how it's got the serrations, the cut glare, awesome. But then the front sight there is that red-orange ramp, keep calling it red-orange, it drops right into that U, pretty good. See that? Check that out. Now that's a cool sight picture. This is the right way to do it. Well, Colt put some, halfway decent rear adjustable sights on their Pythons. Highly doubt it. It's most likely for cost savings. So, anyways, there you go. So I'm just going to show this to you once again. It's a very positive click if you got to go up and down right here. I got to go to the range and zero this in, but as you can hear it, like that. Very, very, very nice, very tactile. You can hear it. You got the side here, left to right, up and down. This is just an incredible rear sight for a very cool revolver. See that sight picture? Very nice. There you go. All right. So, when I get the gold bead front sight, I'll put it on here. I don't have to do another video about it, but that's my plan. I'm going to have to buy a gold bead front sight. I may have given that front sight away to somebody, actually, now that I think about it. So much stuff going on in life. I can't think straight sometimes. But anyways, there you go. You can leave some comments below. Let me know what you think. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.